Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophynet and welcome back to Bioshock in our Let's Replay series. We're back in Olympus Heights because I think, yeah, we're still missing one little sister. So I'm gonna kind of stalk this big daddy here and try to get something out of it. I'm actually gonna check out the Gatherer's Garden in the meantime as well, because we might actually be able to buy one of those engineering slots right over here. There we go. And then we might actually go for shorten alarms. Shorten alarms, there we go. There we go. Yeah, okay, so now he's gonna check out that little sister. And in the meantime, I'm gonna just wrap this place in trap bolts. No, 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 no. Oh, God. He's gonna go in the wrong direction. No, 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 no. Come over here. I have a surprise for you. That's one. That's two. Ooh, that actually did less than I expected. Yeah, he took care of the thingy. Oh, wow, okay, never mind. That's a great way to start an episode. Didn't realize he was that fast behind me. So, yeah. Let's take out that guy again. Sorry for that. That was... Wait, what? How did he go through the first one and the last one, but not the three? That's why he had that much health left. That's not fine. That's not how you should do this. Where's your little sister? She's still there. Okay. Fuck you. I don't like you. Yeah, Mr. Bubbles is gone. I am Mr. Bubbles now, so get over here. And give me some of that delicious Adam. Sploosh! Okay, so that was actually the only thing I wanted to return here for, so... I don't think there's a U-invent handy, otherwise I would have checked that out, but I don't think there is. So I'm gonna go back to Apollo Square immediately right now, so see you guys back right over there in a minute. So, back at Apollo Square, we're heading to the opposite side of where we were before, so past this turret, towards apparently the Hestia Chambers. But there's a building over there that's actually really interesting before we... go any further. I think there's a camera right over there. I'm not gonna... You know what? Actually gonna use armor piercing rounds for that. There we go. Took care of it really, really quickly. And then where the building I'm talking about is right over there. We heard an audio diary of Fontaine talking about it. Because that's actually Fontaine's House of the Poor. Interesting for us, of course. Because we might get a bit more information... Shit, that was missed. Is that someone who is back? Let's try and evade. There we go. And we're really close to another plasmid memory, as you can see. I'm wondering, yeah, here it is. Ryan's gonna be there for you when you're down and out? No! Hey fella, don't you wanna take a walk with me? Fontaine's the man with the helping hand! There we go, more propaganda for Fontaine, the reason how he got his army. Hello! Nope, bye. Goodbye. Goodbye. I think the clicking we hear... Yeah, okay. So the clicking is the bot that we took out. Might actually take that with me. Come along, little bot. Sounding like Santa Cohen right now. Because we can actually enter Fontaine's center. For the poor. And there's actually a dollar. That's actually really funny. There's a dollar underneath Fontaine Center for the Poor. That's really ironic. Made Ryan good and mad when I started playing the charity angle. Fontaine's home for the poor. Before I knew it, I was calling myself Atlas and leading an army. Ryan and his precious raptor. You don't have to build a city to make people worship you. Just make the chumps believe they're worth a nickel. So Fontaine indeed was the smarter man in this case, not that that makes him any better. Because of course he raised his army by gathering the poor into one place. So let's hack this thing, because we can hear a lot of things over here. Don't fire! Yeah, there we go. Bye. I think the turret was gonna fix this. I think the turret is gonna blow itself up in a minute. What is he doing? Stop firing at a corpse. There we go. Money. Okay, and we're already in one of the houses for the poor. Sounds like they did have some shells, though. Let's get the trap, the normal bolts. Take a zoom. There we go. Laughing his head off. Yeah, of course. There we go. And it seems like there's more splicers here as well. So, zooming at the floor all of a sudden. Oh, that didn't go underneath the bed. Let's stand still for a second. There we go. Can't say I'm not using my arsenal, right? I think I pretty much used every weapon in the arsenal. Is there anybody else here? I know this place is kind of a maze. We can actually go down here. Let's check out, because I don't really know this place by heart. Ooh, this guy is strong. There we go. I'm glad you were helping me, bot. Okay, this guy's leg is twitching a bit. Any audio diaries around here? Giving us a better look in this place. There is another UN vent, which I might actually use. An automatic hack tool, which is really, really handy. The really weird, gross noise we hear is actually a little sister drinking blood. So yeah, let's just check this place out. There we go. And what are we missing? We could use trap bolts, I think. I think we're full on electric gel. Used a bit of armor piercing rounds. Maybe that. Yeah, thank you. I think some things were dropped out probably, but there's a giant heap of stuff in front of it, so not really useful for me. Take me home, Mr. Bubbles. I want to kill you, though. Well, Mr. Bubbles, I want to kill Mr. Bubbles and take your Adam little sister. Seems to be a bit of a leak in the Fontaine's home for the poor. So yeah, this place is actually more than what you think it is. It's not just for the poor, because I think... Yeah, there we go. The Little Sisters Orphanage, brought to you by Fontaine Futuristics. We know Fontaine actually funded Tenenbaum's research towards Andem, but Fontaine also provided something else. He used this place, the orphanage, to gather little sisters... Well, little sisters, he gathered little girls to turn them into little sisters. And yeah, that weren't always, as we know right now, not always girls that were orphans. Because we've heard plenty of mothers looking for their children that were abducted for this very reason. I think we can actually, let's go down. And I think I might be able to create a trap for this guy. Huh. Wait a second. Where is he going? He's going upstairs. Huh. You know what? I'm gonna wait with taking him out. Let's see. We're gonna have to go upstairs. Although, you know what? Yeah. So I'm gonna make her angry at me. Let's go with the heat-seeking rockets in this place. Set up a bit of a trap. Set up a bit of a trap. Maybe down the stairs. That's actually interesting. So let's go with that again. So that's one. And if he goes down, okay, there he goes. Yeah. There we go. Taken care of. Yep. Yeah, Mr. Bubbles is gone again. So yeah, our arsenal has grown so much that we can actually easily take out a big daddy right now. And that's our turret again.
I do for these little ones. I am tainted by sins. But you, perhaps you unlock a future for them that I cannot even imagine. A little one heads your way with a gift. Please be careful.
Yes, we will be, Tenenbaum. Yes, we will. So, he has a lot of money, of course. Again, we can't really use that right now. As I said, this game actually gets easier the further we get. Because we have so much at our disposal. But there's one reason I want to be in here. One other reason I want to be in here. Because there's actually a weapon upgrade station in this area as well, if I remember correctly. So we did all the little sisters in this area. We did all the little sisters in the previous area. So we're good to go towards Prometheus Point. Hello, lady. Yeah, that's not really hitting me. You threw that over my head. There we go. Thank you for all of that. Let's just heal kerosene. Don't really need that right now. Not really making anything. I think there's also a trophy for inventing a certain amount of items, and I thought I would have already gotten that one. But apparently we didn't. Oh, okay, wrong one. I was hitting the wrong one. Are you trying to hit me, sir? Are you trying to hit me? Seems like you're failing horrendously. But hey, let's see. I shouldn't follow the arrow, because the arrow is going to try and get us back downstairs towards our next objective. Ooh, this is grim. She died with a few bags of potato chips next to her. So that's this side. I don't think we can actually access the other side. No. So that's the door. That's the other side we could see. But I think at the top floor here, there should be a weapon upgrade station, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so this is one of the only places where you can actually whack away some wood, which is making this a bit weird. So another chemical thrower. Is there anything else here? Because it doesn't look like there is. Oh, yeah. Okay, so now we can drop down to this floor we couldn't really access. Pistol rounds. Can't you really use that? Oh, oh, wow, wow. Okay, didn't expect you guys to wake up. I think I'm healing faster than you can do damage. Is there anything interesting in this place? Apparently there isn't. So this is the window we could see from the other side. I thought there was more in this place than that. But hey, so let's crawl through the window. There we go. And hopefully not break our legs. Ow. Yeah, there we go. So let's head back up. Because I think we actually should... Yeah, okay, so we could go down there, but in this place then, I suppose? Otherwise, I have the worst memory in the world. Okay, well, since you're standing still and all...
All I want to do is meet someone.
Is it true? You just want to meet someone? Is it poison? I think it was a love is an arrow to the head. Apparently. So there seems to be a camera over there. So let's grab the armor piercing rounds. Just take care of the camera. There we go. Like this thing. And here is actually... This is actually a really cool room. This is kind of the propaganda office for Atlas. You can see the press here that was used to create those posters. Right over here. You can see a poster of Andrew Ryan. That is a shot at with a crossbow, so we're actually going to use... I think we can actually get those steel bolts. Let's drop the incendiary bolts, because we're not... We haven't really been using those. There's actually... That's actually the best kind of ammunition in the game. I think she missed us. There we go. I think she did miss us. Kind of got an arrow to the head. Again. So yeah, that's all that. Andrew Ryan getting shot in the face. And let's go downstairs then, I suppose. Oh, I'm hoping this weapon... Oh yeah, there we go. Power to the people station. Let's just check our backs really quickly and activate this thing. So let's go for the chemical thrower range. There we go. So that's our fifth weapon fully upgraded. So we're one short. We need to, we still need two weapon upgrade stations to fully upgrade our pistol. And that should be it, because I don't think I have missed one yet. I, of course, could be completely mistaken, but I don't think I have missed one. And there is another Sonic. Focused Hacker 2. So I think that slows the flow. No. When you have to hack the most delicate systems out there, only Focused Hacker 2 from HackSmart can ensure your safety from overloads. So 4 fewer overload tiles while hacking. So let's swap that out for shorter alarms too. And then the longest calm.
Never play a man for the short con when you can play him for the long one. Atlas is the longest con of all. Ryan wanted Frank Fontaine dead. I just gave him what he wanted. As Atlas, I got a new face, a clean record, and a fresh start. Ryan. Now, it's time to take back Rapture.
Help yourself, please.
Oh, Mrs. McClintock! What are you doing here? Let me just... turn this off.
Okay, so there we go. Confirming that Diane McClintock actually... joined with Fontaine. Well, Atlas, she didn't know that was Fontaine, because otherwise she wouldn't have joined, probably. But there she clearly was in the same audio diary, almost, revealing that Fontaine is actually Atlas. And the other way around. But, another save. There we go, let's auto-hack it. There we go. Dollars, electric bucks. Electric bucks we're gonna be able to use. And then this corpse has another interesting one. Don't know what happened with her corpse, because she kind of got... Looks like she came from very high, otherwise she has been smacked on this desk with a huge force. But let's listen to today's raid. There we go. Nope. There we go.
We went on a raid outside the wire today. We snagged 31 rounds of buckshot, 4 frag grenades, a shotgun, and 34 atom. We lost McGee, Epstein, and Valette. We got one of those goddamn big daddies in the bargain, though. It was something awful they had to do to that little girl to get the atom, but... we didn't start this thing. Ryan did. I can't wait to tell Atlas. He'll be so pleased.
So there we go. I didn't want to tell you guys immediately, but of course, since Diane McClintock stepped in on Fontaine recording his little diary about the long con, he actually realized that she knew who he was. And, we can then assume that this is actually the body of Diane McClintock. Her transformation complete. She went from completely loving Andrew Ryan to hating him and joining up with his uttermost enemy. And then... paying for it. Don't know what happened to her foot over there. Looks really painful, aside from getting smashed into the desk like that. This also indicates how strong Fontaine is. He smacked her onto this desk, bending it completely. A steel desk, bending it like that. So he spliced up really, really good, is something we can guess already. I don't think there was anything else in here. Did we check out the gift? No, we didn't. Now we can drop down again. But I don't think this is an area we couldn't have reached otherwise, right? Yeah, because we have actually searched these guys. So yeah, that's that. I think that's everything in this place, in Fontaine's home for the poor. So I might actually take the rest of the time and we'll head towards Prometheus Point already. Because we've been over there. Yeah, let's go down. Oh, wait, I think... Isn't there a basement in this thing? No, okay. So just a UN vent and a few more vending machines. Don't think there's anything of interest here. Maybe in here? A really weird positioned corpse. Oh, meeting Atlas. There we go. I think this is another one of Diane McClintock. Yeah, there we go.
The people here have grown to trust me. Ryan's mistress, and still they take me in. They finally brought me to Atlas. Without him, the people of Palo Square would give up. I asked him if he was going to lead the people in some kind of uprising against Ryan. He sighed and said,
I am not a liberator. Liberators do not exist. These people will liberate themselves. I thought Andrew Ryan was a great man. I was a fool.
And sadly, you were still a fool. Because, indicating that how good Fontaine is at his cons. Well, we were the victim of him, of his con ourselves. Clearly, because the Atlas con was really, really, really well done. There was almost no indication that that was the same guy. Just looking out the window again. Kind of like looking out of the window. I think that over there is still the fleet hall, but I think logically that it's too close to everything else, or maybe they're just reusing the fleet hall sign everywhere. That could be the reason as well. But Rapture Metro, it's been a while since we actually entered one of these. But we're gonna have to this time, because we're gonna go to Point Prometheus and try to finish this, try to kill Frank Fontaine.
But laying all your chips on Mother Goose, it's not like you never been double-crossed before. You know what I'm saying? Hoof it to Point Prometheus. We'll discuss this like men. You, me, a submarine topside, and more Adam than you can possibly imagine.
So there we go, an invitation, a challenge, that he is at Point Prometheus and he has all the Adam he would want. Indicating that he's probably the strongest splicer in this place. And but more importantly, he also mentioned that there's a submarine waiting for us if we can defeat him. So that's nice. We can actually leave this place if we want to. But before that, of course, we still have a lot of work to do. Seems like there's another... Hi. Don't know how you actually missed... Oh, hi. Hi. Are you gonna go like that? And in the face! Because I actually realized that wrench attacks also do more damage when you hit them in the face. Combine that with Electrobolt, and they get a really nice multiplied shot in the face. There we go, there's another director's commentary. Thank you for that. Not able to just show you guys that, I believe. Tennis ball, for some reason. It's been a while. I think we found tennis balls. We were shot at with tennis balls when we first found telekinesis, so this is... Nostalgia! Woo, look at that. There we go. That was fun. So, with that done, let's go down into the bathysphere over here, which we can use because we're Andrew Ryan's son, and let's pull the lever and go to Point Prometheus. So, as we rise up. There we have Fontaine himself.
All right. You looking to slug it out? I'm game. But I got all the Adam in the city, pal, and I ain't shy about using it. Now, I'm Jake to take her out for a spin.
What is this you wait for? Go and get this idiot!
And as we can see, we knew that already, but he has immense strength. So yeah, that kind of blocked our way a bit. Can't really go through that, right? Can't really go through that. Can't jump on top of this either, so I'm gonna just have to wait and go. There we go. So, Olympus Heights and Apollo Square were the living quarters of all these people. And right now, Point Prometheus actually serves a dual purpose. They're firing, but they're missing. There we go. Took out his bolts with ease. Come over here, Fontaine. Where is he? Okay.
You pack it in now, and I'll beat this stuff to you and Frau Kraut. You keep on coming, and Rapture's a fish tank.
Shy, you let him get away. Oh, I need a moment for thinking. Ah, of course. This will be no problem. Find a Big Daddy and search his body. I would suggest you to be finding a dead one.
And there we go. Tenenbaum has a bit of an idea how we can try and defeat Fontaine. Because as you can see, he has immense strength lifting this one with telekinesis. The other one, that metal statue, just with his bare hands. That guy is amazingly strong. So, a dead Big Daddy, and obviously there's one right here, so let's check it out. Suit control system.
You see the suit control system? The goats get it. That is step one of turning you into one of those disgusting Big Daddies. The only way to get through that door Fontaine went through is to have a little one open it for you. And they will only trust you if you look like, sound like, and even smell like one of those big stinking brutes.
I've always found that a bit weird. It's really, really cool that we get to turn into a Big Daddy. Don't misunderstand me for that. But we have little sisters. We had little sisters opening these doors for us when we first recovered at Tannenbaum's place. So I'm still wondering why she couldn't just send one of those little girls right over here, open the door for me, and let's just move on with it. But then, of course, we wouldn't be able to turn into a Big Daddy. Our, well, aside from one last weapon upgrade system, let's just increase the pistol damage. There we go, look at that, nice little clip around the pistol. Not that I use that often. We can hear a camera, clearly. But we have a lot of things we need to...
Where do you think you're going? You need to become a Big Daddy before you are able to draw out the little ones.
Yeah, we know. But there's a lot more around here, Tannenbaum. Just give me a second. Point Prometheus serves a dual purpose. On the one side, it's an educational center for kids as well as adults, with museums and the like. A library right here as well. So I think, yeah, there's a camera right over there. I think I'm actually gonna hack this one just for old time's sake, and we have enough money, so let's just hack that. And then let's take a look around the library. There's that. Oh! Ow! Couldn't step left for some reason. Yeah, he blew up the camera. That was really nice. That was really, really cute. Hi. Thank you. That was really, really nice. Fuck's sake. And then we have damage research 2. Hit him hard where it hurts and hit him... Oh, hit him where it hurts and hit him hard. New damage research 2 lets you exploit your enemy's weaknesses even more than before. So let's swap that out for the normal damage research. Okay, didn't really know why I healed there. Oh, it's a Houdini splicer. I was kind of afraid that the turret would actually fire on that guy. Well, that woman. So, and here we have the Big Daddy boots. And now we actually sound like a Big Daddy if we walk around. Listen to that.
Why are these boots here? They should be in fail-safe armored escorts. No matter. Take them.
So as she mentioned, they shouldn't be here in the library. Because obviously, why would there be Big Daddy boots in the library? But then again, it's actually really nice because now we have those already. So now we sound like a Big Daddy. I think that's gonna cut into our stealth a little bit, but never mind. There we go. Let's take out the health kit. Notice. That sounds like a spider splicer, but I think the turret has this locked. Don't really need to do anything, right? Just fire away, I would say. So there's little bits and little bits of things in the bookshelves around here, because I think, yeah. Thank you. Well done, turret. Well done. Thanks for killing that spider splicer for me.
Where are you gonna go? Your life? Your family? They're a fairy tale, kid. No more real than something you read about in the Saturday Evening Post. Poor bastard. A motherless freak. Whipped up in a half-baked science experiment.
There we go. So Fontaine instigating us a bit about the fact that we don't have anything to go to because we're a science experiment, don't have a life, la 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 la, yada yada yada. Can we go through here? No, we can't, but we can go right here. So if we stand still, we can actually use our crossbow. We kind of missed there. Is it going to turn back? I'm going to turn back because right now I'm invisible. Because maybe... it's not friendly. It's really not... Oh, shit! Okay, then. Fuck off. I think the noise is going crazy again. Okay. Another turret, and there goes the little sister that left us another gift. So let's search that. 200 atom, prolific inventor, and 150 liquid nitrogen. There we go. Inventing is already a valuable pastime in the resource-strapped halls of Rapture. Make yourself a prolific inventor, and you'll be the envy of your peers, as you turn worthless junk into valuable commodities. Whenever you invent an item, you get twice as many as normal. Which is actually really cool, but I'm just gonna wait until we can buy the next stult, which will actually be in a second. These are right in front of a gatherer's garden. So let's buy the last engineering tonic slot and put in prolific inventor. Okay, so the other things we can buy is of course another plasmid slot. And I think I'm gonna do that together with, let's do that. And I think we got a trophy for that, yeah, because we maxed all tracks. Let's put Security Bullseye in there for now. But we're gonna buy Winter Blast as well. Freeze even the toughest foe in his tracks with Winter Blast 3, the ultimate in stopping power. So I'm gonna swap out Security Bullseye for that. And then we could still buy... Ooh, Human Inferno 2. Was that there before? There we go, let's swap that out for Human Inferno. There we go, nice, and that's about all we can do. So now we have Winter Blast available to us. Let's smack this thing. And now let's take a look around, because there's a few areas around here. So we could go to the museum is downstairs. But that's where we actually couldn't, I think we can actually, yeah, we can jump down and get to there as well. Because this is where we came from, and I think, yeah, okay, so there's the museum is over there. But it's the other door we need to enter.
Andrew Ryan asks you a simple
question. Yeah, Andrew Ryan asks a simple question. Yeah, because a man chooses a slave or base. So we have optimized eugenics to the left. We have Little Wonders educational facility for the kids. And then we have safe, fail-safe armored escort. All three areas that we're going to need to visit to complete the Big Daddy set. But with that said, we're gonna take a little break right here at Point Prometheus, and next time we're gonna try and become a complete Big Daddy, not just the boots, not just this stomping around, because that would be a bit weird, right? So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube, and if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye.